Hello friends, myself Sandeep N. Palle, Department of Mechanical Engineering, MEP Samajar, KBT College of Engineering, Nasik. Today's topic is sliding contact bearing, second part, in which we will see primarily and void method. The first part in this is design consideration in hydrodynamic bearing. The design of bearing consists of various parameters. These parameters, they are categorized in two groups: design parameter and performance parameter. Design of hydrodynamic bearing, it consists of defining the satisfactory limit for the performance variable and then deciding the values of design variables such that the performance variable do not exceed the defined limit. Means you have to set the limit for performance variable and accordingly you have to make the modification in design variable. What is the design variable thing? The variables which are under the control of designer. The major design variables are speed of journal, viscosity of fluid, load per unit projected area, bearing dimension such as radius, length and CPM. Out of these four, the speed of journal is actually specified by the application. So it is not in total control of the designer, but rest of the parameters, they are under control of designer. Next one is performance variable. The variables which are used to analyze the performance of the bearing, they are called performance variables. They are coefficient of friction, minimum oil film thickness, temperature rise of the fluid, and flow rate of lubricant. This group of variables, it tells us how well the bearing is performing. Now, the designer has to impose some limitation on this value, and after that, by considering those limitations, the design variable has to modify so that this limit should not exceed it. So the designer, it can indirectly control this performance variable by changing one or more of the design variables. These variables are very important for the satisfactory performance of the bearing. Next one is Raimondi and Boyd method. Reynolds equation for finite length of bearing is shown here. This is the Reynolds equation for the finite length bearing. There is no exact analytical solution to this differential equation. So, Albert Raimondi and John Boyd solve this equation by using iteration technique. As a result of this, the solution they express the performance of hydrodynamic bearing in terms of certain dimensionless parameter. These dimensionless parameters are made by combining different design and performance variables. These dimensionless parameters are available in the form of chart or table. The chart and table, they are available for full and partial journal bearing having L by D ratio as infinity, 1, 1 by 2 and 1 by 4. Look at this table. Here L by D ratio is given 1 and the different parameters, they are mentioned here. E, eccentricity ratio, epsilon, eccentricity ratio, मिनिमम फ्लूइड फिल्म थिकनेस रेशियो एच नॉट बाय सी, समरफेल्ड नंबर, एटीट्यूड एंगल, कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शनल वेरिएबल आर सी अपॉन आर अपॉन सी इंटू एफ, फ्लो वेरिएबल क्यू अपॉन आर सी एन एस एल, फ्लो रेशियो क्यू अपॉन क्यू एफ, मैक्सिमम फिल्म प्रेशर रेशियो पी अपॉन पी मैक्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल कैलकुलेट द एल बाई डी रेशियो एंड देन विल कैलकुलेट द समरफेल्ड नंबर। इफ एल बाई डी रेशियो इज वन एंड समरफेल्ड नंबर इज 0.121, देन विल कंसिडर दिस रो एंड बाय टेकिंग द वैल्यू फॉर डिफरेंट वेरिएबल्स और पैरामीटर्स वी कैन फाइंड आउट द रिक्वायर्ड पैरामीटर। फॉर एग्जाम्पल फॉर एल बाई डी रेशियो 1 एंड समरफेल्ड नंबर 0.121 वी कैन हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन वेरिएबल 3.22। फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन एफ। सिमिलरली फॉर फ्लो रेशियो वी हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ 4.33, वी कैन गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ टोटल फ्लो क्यू। फ्रॉम दिस वैल्यू वी कैन गेट द साइड लीकेज एंड फ्रॉम दिस वैल्यू वी कैन गेट द मैक्सिमम प्रेशर। नेक्स्ट कम डायमेंशनलेस पैरामीटर। द फर्स्ट वन इज समरफेल्ड नंबर, इट इज डिनोटेड बाय एस। इट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट डायमेंशनलेस पैरामीटर। इट कंटेन्स ऑल द वेरिएबल विच आर कंट्रोल्ड बाय द डिजाइनर। इट इज गिवन बाय एस इक्वल टू आर अपॉन सी ब्रैकेट स्क्वायर इनटू जेड एन एस अपॉन पी। आर इज द रेडियस ऑफ शाफ्ट, is the radial clearance, z is the viscosity, n is the speed in rps and is the unit bearing pressure. Minimum film thickness variable is given by h naught by c. Next is eccentricity ratio. It is the ratio of eccentricity to the radial clearance. It is given by epsilon. As we know, minimum film thickness is h naught is equal to c minus e. So c is common, 1 minus e upon c, which will become epsilon. So epsilon is equal to 1 minus h naught by c. Then angle of eccentricity or attitude angle denoted by phi, it gives the angular position of minimum film thickness with respect to the direction of load. Next is coefficient of friction variable, CFV is equal to R upon C into F, radius of shaft, radial clearance and coefficient of friction. The next one is flow variable is equal to FV is equal to Q upon R into C into NS into L, total oil flow, radius of shaft, radial clearance, speed of shaft in RPS and length of bearing. Then side leakage is given by QS upon Q and maximum film pressure ratio is given by P upon P max. Next curve is temperature rise in bearing. As there is a oil in bearing which has viscosity, so because of that there is a friction in the layers of the oil, so the frictional work will generate the heat and the heat will increase the temperature of the lubricating oil. Now this total heat that should be carried by the oil flow in the bearing, so how much amount of heat is generated? So the amount of heat generated, Hg, is nothing but the amount of power loss in the fluid friction. So Hg is given by 2 pi ns Fwr upon 10^6 kilowatt, equation number 1. Now this amount of heat generated should be dissipated and this heat is carried by the oil. So heat dissipation is given by mCp delta T. M is the mass of lubricating oil. Cp is the specific heat of lubricating oil. It is in kilojoule per kg degree Celsius. Delta T is the change in temperature in degree Celsius. Now mass is equal to rho into Q. Rho is the mass density of lubricating oil in kg per meter cube, and Q is the total flow rate of lubricating oil in mm cube per second. Here it is in kg per meter cube, here in mm cube per second. So to convert this meter into mm, 10 raised to 9 is here. This is the equation number second. So the amount of heat generated should be carried by total oil flow. So equating these two equation, we'll get the equation for delta T is equal to 2 pi ns fwr upon rho q cp into 10 raised to 3 degree Celsius. Now this equation we can also write in terms of dimensionless parameter. We know the coefficient of flow variable, friction variable, r upon c into f, which can give f is equal to cfe into c upon r, and flow variable q upon rc nsl will give Q is equal to Fe into RC NSL. By putting this value in the above equation, we can get delta T is equal to 4 pi P upon rho Cp into Cfe upon Fe into 10 raised to 3. The average temperature of the lubricating oil is given by T average is equal to T1 plus delta T by 2, where T1 is the temperature in the inlet. Next is the bearing design, that is the selection of parameter. In the design of bearing, it is required to select suitable values for some important parameter. Those are, first one, length to diameter ratio. In design of bearing, diameter is known from the strength consideration. So it is not depend on the bearing capacity. So bearing length is the only parameter that designer has to select. L by D ratio affects the performance of the bearing. If the long bearing is there, it has more load carrying capacity. On the other hand, the short bearing, that is L by D ratio, is small, then it has improved heat dissipation because side flow is more. The second one is load per unit projected area, is denoted by P. The permissible value of the load per unit area, it depends on bearing material, operating temperature, type of load, and its service condition. For different applications, the value of this load per area, it is given in the table format. So designer has to select the appropriate value. Then come the starting load or startup load. It is defined as the load acting at stationary condition. It consists of weight of the shaft and its attachment. It is used to determine the minimum length of bearing at the starting condition. The load per unit projected area for this, it should not exceed 2 Newton per mm square. The next one is radial clearance, denoted by C. The effect of radial clearance is that if it is small, it provides necessary velocity gradient. But for this purpose, we must have the surface finish of the contacting surface very well, and it could require fine finishing operation and which are costly. So it will increase the cost of initial cost and the running cost of bearing. The commonly used values of radial clearance for the bearing are given here. Precision bearing 0.001R to 0.0015R. General machinery bearing 0.0015 to 0.0025. And this. Next is minimum oil film thickness. It depends upon surface finish of bearing and journal, viscosity of oil, and the type of load. The lower limit for is mentioned. H naught should be equal to 0.0002 into R. And the last one is maximum oil film temperature. The lubricating oil tends to oxidize when operating temperature is 120 degrees Celsius. Also, the various bearing material, they soften beyond 125 degrees Celsius. So limiting temperature is considered for the design is 90 degrees Celsius. Okay. Thank you.